Hello, I'm Dr. Beth Colby from Talk Mental Health. I'm a psychiatrist in London. This talk today is on affective disorders. Affective means mood, and the disorders that come under this category that I'm going to talk about are bipolar affective disorder, depression, recurrent depressive disorder, and two other conditions called cyclothymia and dysthymia. Bipolar affective disorder. Bipolar means two poles, so that's opposite ends of the mood spectrum, very high and very low. It used to be called manic depression. So if somebody's manic, the term mania means that they're euphoric, excessively excited, and very, very happy. They may talk fast, act fast. They may be reckless sexually or spend lots of money on things they normally wouldn't want and can't afford. They may use drugs and alcohol. They may have a decreased need for sleep. They may have lots of different ideas and schemes that they want to do and have an overinflated view of themselves and their abilities. And at the far end, they may become delusional, so they'll have delusions. The depressed part of it, people will have low mood, decreased interest and enjoyment in activities they'd normally enjoy, low energy, low concentration and attention, low self-esteem and self-confidence, ideas of guilt and unworthiness, bleak and pessimistic views of the future, ideas or acts of self-harm or suicide, and altered appetite and sleep. Bipolar affective disorder, there's bipolar 1, which I've talked about, the episode of mania. Bipolar 2, people have to have an episode of hypomania, which I'll mention, and an episode of depression. So hypomania is not as severe as mania, although they'll have similar symptoms, but people are less likely to be admitted to hospital, and they will be able to carry on their day-to-day activities like going to work, looking after their children, their home, whatever they normally would do during the week. But people who know them would be able to recognise that their mood is higher than normal and their behaviour is altered as well. So that's a lesser form of mania. So that's bipolar affective disorder. The next disorder I'm going to talk about is depressive disorder. I've talked about the symptoms of depression in that, so I won't go much further, but these are categorised into their severity, so it could be mild, moderate or severe, and also at the lower end of the spectrum, when people are very depressed, they may have psychotic symptoms, they may get suicidal ideas. So we tend to say if it's mild, moderate or severe, with or without psychotic symptoms, with or without ideas or acts of self-harm, thoughts of suicide. Then the two persistent mood disorders, so these are longer term, are cyclothymia, where people's mood does go up or down, so they could be mildly elated for a while, then the mood may be normal for them, then they may be depressed for a while. But either the elation or the depression isn't as severe to warrant a diagnosis of mania or hypomania or depression, but it still affects people's lives negatively. And the second one is dysthymia, where people's mood isn't right and they're low in mood for long periods of time and persistently, like throughout their adult life. But there again, it's not as severe to warrant a diagnosis of depression. So that's the mood or affective disorders. Remember to like, subscribe and make a comment or suggestion. Thank you very much. It's Dr. Beth Colby from Talk Mental Health. Bye-bye.